Quiet down and roll camera.
Speed.
Take one.
And action.
RSI, crime scene investigation.
4 seconds.
First of Sesame Street Spoofs, volume 2.
And now it's time once again for that famous detective and solver of nursery rhyme crimes, Columbo. Today's episode, The Great Plum Plunder.
It was a quiet night in the detective world. I was hungry for a case. And come to think of it, I was also hungry for a snack. Then it hit me. I decided to have a piece of Christmas pie that the missus had baked for me. When I looked at the pie, I discovered a plum was missing. Just then, I noticed someone sitting in the corner. It was the janitor, little Jack Horner.
Hey, Jack, how you doing?
I'm fine. Just fine. Yeah, what makes you think I wouldn't be fine? I didn't do anything, you know.
I didn't say you did anything, Jack, but I would like to ask you a question. You know, a question's a good way of finding something out.
I know that. Go ahead, ask me. I got nothing to hide.
All right. What were you doing in the corner?
Sitting? Just sitting. Yeah, sitting in the corner.
So, little Jack Horner was sitting in the corner.
Yeah, that's right. I was just sitting in the corner. No law against sitting in the corner, is there?
No, Jack, I don't think there is. Thank you very much for your time.
Any time, Columbo.
Oh, one more question.
Hmm?
What were you doing while you were sitting in the corner?
I was eating. Yeah, eating.
So, little Jack Horner was sitting in the corner eating, eh?
Yeah, that's right. Nothing wrong with that, is there?
No. Everybody's got to eat, Jack. Thanks again. Oh, one more question.
Another question?
Hey, like I said, questions are a good way to find things out. Now, you ready for this question?
Yeah. Go ahead and ask already.
You got thumbs?
Of course I got thumbs. Look!
Aha! I think I solved the mystery. Little Jack Horner was sitting in the corner eating my Christmas pie. He stuck in his thumb, pulled out my plum, and said, "What a bad boy am I." Is that the story, Jack? Is that what happened?
Yeah, I guess you're too smart for me, Columbo.
You know what this means, don't you, kid?
Yeah, it means you're sending me up the river. I'm going to the big house. I'm going to do 20 years hard labor. I'm going to the slammer.
You're
going to
explain to my wife what happened to her pie.
Oh, no. I thought he'd go easier on a first-time offender.
Oh, and one more thing. Clean up those crumbs.
Sure. It's my job.
And so another exciting nursery rhyme crime is solved with the help of Columbo. And now, let's join the crew of Spaceship Surprise as they travel through space in search of new stars and planets.
Captain, I may have asked you this before, but why do we always keep traveling from planet to planet? Captain?
Because we love surprises!
Surprise!
Surprised you, didn't I?
I think we've just landed again, Captain.
Another surprise! Don't you love it? Let's venture out and be surprised some more.
Yes, Captain.
Make it so, number two. Engage the door.
Yes, Captain. Interesting. I wonder where we are.
We're here.
Yes, but where is here?
Good question.
Howdy!
Is that a hopping hamster? Or am I still dizzy from our landing?
I'm a hopping hamster, all right, and I've come to welcome you to the Planet H.
The Planet H?
You got it. We call it the Planet H on account of how everything here is starting with the letter H. I am Hopalong Hamster, the head honcho here.
Oh, I get it. That must be why you have those hula hoops and all these harps.
With hair.
That's right, because hula hoops, harps, and hair all begin with the letter H.
This Planet H sure is a surprising place.
Oh, and you haven't seen the half of it yet.
What's that?
Oh, that's Happy Harry, the hopping haystack. Howdy, Harry.
Howdy, Hopalong.
A hopping haystack? Gee, what other surprising things do you have here on Planet H?
Let's see now. We got hens that dance a Hawaiian hula. Send in the hula hens.
Hula hens?
Play the music a little faster, boys. That's it. Looking good, girls. Hey, yeah. Oh, that's another thing that we have. Hey, falling out of the heavens. That's we got.
Hey,
that.
Anyone else need a little bit more hay?
This Planet H is very surprising.
You can say that again.
Never mind.
And so, everyone in Planet H danced the Hawaiian hula until it was time to say...
Y'all hurry back now, here! Hula! Hula!
Join us again one of these years for another exciting adventure with Spaceship Surprise!
Yes. Now, my pets, make yourselves comfortable. Yes, it's time for our favorite television program, 6 Feet Under. Yes, quiet, my pets. It begins.
And now, tonight's episode of 6 Feet Under.
Hey, hey, feet off the table. Get your feet off the table.
Ah, and now we see the feet, my pet, under the table. I shall count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 feet. 6 feet under.
I want to eat. I want the food. I want to eat. You're kicking me.
Oh, an excellent program, my pets. What should we watch next? Three's Company? 8 is enough? 60 minutes? I am one happy couch potato. That's one happy couch potato. West Baseland, my foot.
5 minutes, Dr. Phil.
Well, actually, Bones, I'm ready to go.
Okay. Hi, and welcome to the Dr. Phil Show.
I'm sorry, who are you?
I'm Dr. Phil. Who are you?
Well, I'm Dr. Phil. This is my show.
I'm sorry, Dr. Phil? What'd you say?
I said this is my show, the Dr. Phil Show.
Well, Dr. Phil, I mean, this is, in fact, my show, the Dr. Phil Show.
Well, Dr. Phil, maybe this will clear things up. Bones, put up the sign. This is the sign for my show, Dr. Phil. You notice it says Dr. Phil.
Yes.
So you see, Dr. Phil, this proves that this is my show.
Oh, I see, Dr. Phil. I see, all right. But I, too, have a sign. Pete, put up my sign. You see, that sign right there, it says Dr. Phil. So you see, Dr. Phil, this is, in fact, my show.
Look, Dr. Phil, I have a show in a minute. You need to go.
Well, this is gonna be the changing day of your life then, because I have a show, too, and I need you to leave. I'm in the middle of it. My show, Dr. Phil, this is mine.
My show, Dr. Phil.
My show!
It's my show.
It's my show. All right, Dr. Phil. I can feel that you are feeling angry.
I am feeling a bit angry. I have to tell you.
Yeah, well, I can feel your feelings because I too am feeling angry.
Well, how's that working for you?
Well, it's not working too good, Dr. Phil. It's not working too good. I don't like to feel angry.
I know how you feel, Dr. Phil. I don't like to feel angry either.
Well, we have quite a problem, Dr. Phil. I say this is my show. You say this is your show. What are we gonna do?
Well, let's think. You say it's the Dr. Phil show. Mm-hmm. I say it's the Dr. Phil show. I've got it, Dr. Phil.
What is it, Dr. Phil?
Welcome to the Dr. Phil
and Dr. Phil Show.
The show where we work out our differences.
That's right. You know, I feel really happy about this, Dr. Phil.
Well, I feel happy too, Dr. Phil.
And I feel you feeling my happiness.
Well, I feel you feeling me feel your happiness.
And I feel you feeling me feeling you feel your happiness.
Yes, it is now, my pets, time for our favorite television program, 24. Yes, and the entire show takes place in 24 seconds, and we get to count each second. Yes.
And now, tonight's episode of 24.
Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 24 seconds! Oh, that was almost too much excitement. Oh, let me catch my breath. Oh, what will they do for the next episode? I cannot wait. Oh, what shall I do? I know. I will count the seconds until the next episode. One, two, three. Isn't life beautiful? Four, five, six.
Coming soon to the Bloom Network. The show everyone's talking about, Desperate Houseplants. It's the story of some houseplants who were not getting what they needed.
Oh, I can't take it anymore. I've lost my bloom. I haven't been watered in days. Oh.
Me neither. I'm not growing. I need sun. But that's all right. I don't want to complain.
I can't go on like this.
Well, neither can I, but I'm not complaining.
The plants were desperate for water and sunlight until one day...
Oh, look! Is that the gardener?
Ooh, yeah! And I think he's got his watering can. Oh, but he's probably busy. But I'm still not complaining.
I hope he notices us.
Ooh, your soil looks dry. You need water. Yeah. Ooh, and you look like you need some sun.
That's true.
Knows what a plant needs.
Yeah, I've never felt so alive. I hope it wasn't too much of a burden.
Be sure to watch Desperate Houseplants every night on the Bloom Network. It'll grow on you.
Antiseptic!
In the alphabet system, there are 26 letters. The detectives who investigate these ABCs are members of an elite squad called... the Special Letters Unit. These are their stories.
Okay, gather around, everybody. Gather around here.
What is it, Captain?
All right, we got a missing letter, and it looks like this.
I know that letter.
Yeah, me too, Captain. Yeah, I've seen it before.
M. It's the letter M.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Good. That's right. Now go out there and find that M.
Okay, right. Captain. Okay,
got it.
Today!
Okay, got it. Captain, I found the missing M.
Where is it?
Right here.
This doesn't look anything like the letter M.
Oh, yeah? Well, listen to this. See that? Moo starts with the letter M. So this must be the letter M.
Maloney, this isn't the letter M. It's a cow.
It is.
You can go now, Bessie.
The name's Murray.
All right, come on.
Quack.
Come on.
Quack.
Come on.
Quack.
Come on.
Quack.
Hey, Captain!
Look at
this.
What?
I found the letter M.
Where?
Right here.
This isn't the letter M. It's a duck.
But not just any duck. I am a mallard.
Mm-hmm, that's right. And mallard starts with the letter M.
Well, that may be, Munch, but it still isn't an M. It doesn't look anything like an M.
See, that's what I tried to tell him, but who listens to a talking piece of poultry?
He's asleep.
Yeah, well, you better wake him up.
I ain't gonna wake him, you wake him.
No way.
Hey, I know. What? Can you do that chung-chung thing again?
Where is that missing letter M?
Huh? Sorry, Captain. Mm. We looked everywhere, but no luck.
Yeah, we just couldn't find the missing M.
Nothing.
Excuse me, could you tell me which way to the men's room?
Sure, down the hallway to the left.
Hey, wait a minute. Hold her right there.
What? What I do?
You're the missing M.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Sure you are. You look exactly like the missing M. See?
Oh, yeah, but I got a mustache. See?
Yeah,
that's
true.
Yeah.
Mercy!
Oh,
it's
the letter M!
All right! I confess! I am the letter M!
We did it.
We found the missing M!
Right.
All in a day's work for Law and Order Special Letters Unit.
You know, that chung-chung thing can really get on one's nerves. Okay, enough chung-chunging already. Mommy! Oh, make it stop! Please!
I love a quiet night at home reading.
Surprise! Welcome to America's newest really real reality show. Really.
You! What are you doing here?
I am here to give your home an
outrageous makeover!
I don't want an outrageous makeover.
Well, of course you do. I mean, just take a look at this non-outrageous door here.
What's wrong with my door?
Well, nothing, sir. It is just that this is one boring door. I mean, where's the outrageousness? You need
an outrageous makeover!
Okay, here we go. Let's get this table out of the way.
All right, sir.
All right, here we go. Hold it up. Okay, I want you back.
Okay.
Coming through. Here's my lever. I need a lever.
Here we go. Okay, we're going to rip right through this drywall. Rip right through it. That's going to give me a stone.
Hey, what are you doing there? What's going on?
Hey, look out. You're pulling up my shag rug.
Looking good, right?
Oh, you're really good. I like it.
What did they do?
Well, sir, they added a door.
There
was one door, and we put in another door.
Yeah, but...
And now there are two doors.
Yeah, but why?
Well, sir, one door is for coming, and the other is for going. Is that not
outrageous?
Yes, it is. It's really outrageous.
Well, I do not think it is outrageous enough.
What?
We need a more
outrageous makeover!
Come on, let's get to
work. Let's go.
No, please, I don't want anything else. I'm fine the way things are. You can all leave now.
Oh, no, sir. Not until you feast your eyes on this
outrageous makeover.
Oh, what now?
That is
no.
Oh, yes, you had two doors, and we added one more door, so now there are one, two, three doors all together. Is that not
outrageous?
Yes.
Do you love it?
No.
You know what? Neither do I. We need another
outrageous makeover!
Come
on, let's go over there.
Wait. Please go away. I just want to read War and Peace in peace. I don't want any more outrageousness.
Oh, come now, sir. There is always room for more outrageousness on me.
Outrageous makeover!
Now, check this out.
Do I have to?
Of course.
Yeah. That looks good.
Yes,
that looks
nice. Good.
Good job.
Thank you, guys. You see, there were three doors, mm-hmm. and we added one more door, may I say rather artistically, and now there are one, two, three, four doors. Is that not
outrageous?
Yes, it is. It's totally outrageous, and I'm outraged at your outrageousness.
I sense you are not happy.
Well, that's because I'm not happy. I'm not happy at all.
But why is that, sir?
Because I don't want four doors. I want you to get rid of the doors. Just lose the doors.
Well, that is not a problem, sir. We shall get rid of the doors.
Really?
Of course. Absolutely. Hey, Stevie, 86 the doors!
Great.
Oh, yes. Oh, thanks. I'm sorry I lost my temper there.
No problem, sir. Here at
Outrageous Makeover Home Edition.
We want you to be happy with your home.
Well, I appreciate that.
Good job, fellas. Good work.
There.
Well... No, where's my door? Now there's no door at all.
Yeah, it is gone, that is right. There were four doors, and we subtracted four doors, and now there are zero doors. Mm. Is that not
outrageous?
If you're going to cry in gratitude, sir, do it to camera three.
Get out! Out!
Yeah, yes,
get
sir!
Get out!
Yes, of course, sir! We understand you wish to be alone, to savor your...
Out!
Yes, out! Whatever! Sir, little problem.
What now?
I cannot go. There is no door. Stevie, tell the crew we will be spending the night.
Why me?
You have a hot tub. Are you getting the crying? I think there's value here.
Coming up next, the hit alphabet show of the season, A's Anatomy.
Observe, lowly medical students. I, Dr. Grover,
alphabet specialist, will teach you everything there is to know about alphabet medicine. What is it? What is it?
It's an ambulance, Dr. Grover.
Of course, an ambulance.
Alphabet emergency! Alphabet emergency! Is this the Alphabet Memorial Hospital?
Yes, and I, Dr. Grover, am the alphabet specialist. You may put me down now. What seems to be the problem?
It's the letter A.
But this does not look like the letter A.
I had an accident. Accident begins with the letter A. Accident.
Yes, I know. I am an alphabet specialist. What happened to you, letter A?
An amateur acrobat was eating an apple while doing an arabesque, and she accidentally landed on me.
How awful.
How abominable.
Can you make me all better, Dr. Grover?
Absolutely. I am an alphabet specialist. Do not worry, letter A. I, Dr. Grover, will put you back together again. Observe and learn, lowly medical students. First, I'll check the abdomen, the adenoids, and the alveolus. Everything looks A-okay to me. Aha, here is the problem. Anvil.
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 Adhesive tape.
Adhesive tape.
Adhesive tape.
Artichoke.
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 Appetizing. Aha, here we are, the letter A, good as new.
But I don't feel at all like myself.
That's not the letter A, Dr. Grover.
What? Of course it is not. I just wanted to see if you've been paying attention.
Attention starts with the letter A. Attention.
Yes, I know. I am an alphabet specialist.
Alphabet starts with the letter A.
Yes, I know. Alphabet. Has anyone ever told you you're annoying?
Annoying starts with the letter A. Annoying.
Now watch while I assemble the letter A.
Assemble starts with the...
Antiseptic!
Antiseptic!
Alpenhorn!
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 At last, the letter A!
I'm still feeling a little out of alignment. You know, I'm very fussy about my appearance.
That still doesn't look like the letter A, Dr. Grover.
Something does seem to be amiss. Bring in the letter A skeleton.
Ah, the letter A skeleton.
Is this it, Doctor?
Yes, thank you. Now, let us study the A's anatomy to see how it is put together. As you can see, lowly students, the A has a line going this way at an angle.
Oh.
And another line over here going at an angle.
Yeah.
And another cute little line in the middle.
Oh.
Like this, Dr. Grover?
Yes, that is right. Yeah. The surgery was a success after all!
I'm all better. I feel like my old self again. Now I can go start words like actor, an astronaut, and agglutination. Well, adios.
Goodbye! One day you too will become alphabet specialists like myself. No need to thank me. I am first and foremost a teacher. Anyone know what agglutination means?
We interrupt this program just cause we feel like it. So there. And now, here's Anderson Cooper of CNN filling in for Oscar the Grouch of GNN.
This is Anderson Cooper in for Oscar the Grouch, who's on assignment at the dump. I'm here with two legendary Grouch newscasters, Dan Rather Not and Walter Cranky, to discuss today's letter in the news, the letter G. Say hello, Dan Rather Not.
I'd rather not!
Walter?
Grr!
I can see this is going to be a tough assignment. Now, our latest GNN news poll shows that some grouches think the letter G is a grouchy letter because it starts words like goo, g-g-goo, and garbage, g-g-garbage, and gastroenteritis, g-g-gastroenteritis. But some grouches think the letter G is not a grouchy letter because it starts nice words like good, good, and gumdrop, gumdrop, and giggle, giggle. We'll ask the experts. Do you think the letter G is grouchy or not grouchy? Tell us, Dan, rather not.
I'd rather not.
That's what you're here for, though, just to give us your opinion. Come on, just tell us what you think.
I'd rather not.
How about you, Walter Cranky? Is the letter G grouchy or not grouchy? Can you elaborate? All right, let me ask the question in another way. Is the letter G grouchy or not grouchy? Tell us what your answer is, Dan, rather not.
I'd rather not.
Walter Cranky? I knew you were going to say that. I've been in some tight spots before, but nothing compared to this. Think, Anderson, what would Oscar do?
I tell you what I'd do. I'd answer the question myself.
I should have thought of that.
Well, you got a lot to learn about grouch journalism, Cooper. Of course, the letter G is grouchy. It's the first letter of the word grouch. Grouch! How much grouchier can you get?
Do you agree? Tell me, Dan, rather not.
I'd rather not.
How about you, Walter Cranky?
Gah!
These guys never answer the question.
Yeah, that's what made them great. Well, this is Oscar the Grouch of the Grouch News Network. Join us tomorrow when our guests will be Meredith Beware and Diane Spoiler. Care to join us?
I'd rather not.
Well, all right. That attitude could get you a job with GNN.
Ugh, never.
You're hired. We now return you to our irregularly scheduled program. Schmat. Oh.
Joe Doe.
June Moon.
Rhyme Squad. RSI.
RSI?
There are a million rhymes in the pretty city, and when there's rhyme in the streets, it's time for RSI, Crime Scene Investigation.
Got a flash, you. We're rhyming, sir.
At, fat, vat, brat, slat, sat.
And smat.
Why?
Because I lost something that rhymes with at.
What?
I forgot.
He's lost something that rhymes with at.
Fat, vat, brat, slat, sat, and schmat. What do we got on schmat?
What?
Schmat.
Spat, sprat, chat, flat, muskrat.
You lose a muskrat, sir? A flat muskrat?
Nope. I'll know it when I see it.
Nat, round up the usual at rhymes.
It's America's most wanted at rhyme, sir.
Howdy!
Did you lose a hat?
Nope.
Meow.
A cat?
Nope.
A bat?
Call me Slugger.
Nope.
A splat. You lose that?
Nope.
So let's get this straight. You lost something that rhymes with at.
Yep.
But it isn't fat, vat, brat, slat, sat, schmat.
Spat, sprat, chat, flat, muskrat.
Hat, cat, mat, bat, or splat.
It's something else.
That rhymes with at.
Yes!
What is it?
It's my dog!
What? Sir, dog does not rhyme with at.
Mine does. Hey, Pat! Pat! Here, Pat! Oh, here's a good boy. That's my good boy.
That dog's name is Pat.
Pat, which rhymes with
hat,
at,
fat, vat, brat, slat, sat, schmat, spat, sprat, chat, flat, muskrat, hat, cat, mat, bat, and splat.
And that's that. Sir, you should have got a cat.
And now it's time once again for the show that really, really rocks. Then rocks some more. 30 Rocks.
The rocks are late. I need 30 rocks for the rock sketch. Where are they?
Lemon! Looking for a Liz Lemon here!
Yeah, right over here.
Anybody by the name of Lemon?
That would be me.
Oh, hey, I got a delivery
for
you.
Yes, do you have the 30 rocks?
Do these look like marshmallows? Woo! Those are some special rocks, by the way. Come all the way from Rockville Center.
Well, that's very interesting.
Yeah, well, gotta go rock around the clock. See you later.
Thank you.
Lemon.
Yes, Jack.
Did the 30 rocks show up for the rock sketch?
Yes, Jack.
Where are they?
Well, Jack, they're right in front of you.
Oh, ha. I knew that. Huh. You think I thought those were marshmallows?
No.
I'll be in my office. Mm. Wait a minute. Mm? How do you know there are 30 rocks here?
Well, that's what I ordered.
But do you know how many rocks are here? I mean, there could be 50 or 100 or 3.
Well, we can find out, Jack.
How? We can't ask them. They're rocks. Mm-hmm. I know. I'll call the boys in accounting.
Wait, Jack. We could do it.
Lemon. We both don't have to make the same call.
No, Jack. We can count the rocks.
I'm the boss, Lemon. You count the rocks.
Okay. Jack. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 30 rocks.
Good job, Lemon.
Thank you.
I'll be in my office. Oh, by the way, did the 2,000 ping pong balls come yet?
Not yet, Jack.
Oh. Well, let me know when they get here.
They're here, Jack.
Yes. But how do we know there are 2,000?
You could count them!
The Dizzy Channel is proud to present the original Dizzy Channel movie that's got all the kids going goofy. It's Preschool Musical.
Welcome to our preschool.
It's not a high school, but it's still cool.
We got mats to take naps, milk cartons to sip.
And it's show and tell, you'll see Timmy's pirate ship.
You can play with our guinea pigs.
You can do lots of things.
But whatever you do, you gotta sing. 'Cause this is
Trey, and I'm ready to rock as I move to block corner to play with the blocks.
Let's move to block corner and play with the blocks. You can play with blocks and
preschool
musical.
Preschool musical, yeah, preschool musical.
Stop sustaining that note. It isn't all about block corner, you know.
What?
Mariella's my name. Tell you what's up. I like to go to dress up corner, 'cause I like to dress up. Let's all go to dress up corner and let's all dress up. Let's all dress up in preschool.
got blocks that are square in preschool.
I can put on green hair in preschool.
I got a rectangle shape in preschool.
I wear a superhero cape in preschool.
The corner.
Dress up corner.
The corner.
Dress up corner.
The corner.
Dress up corner.
Hey, wait.
Huh? What?
I have an idea. My name is Alice Birds. And we can do both things. We can just take turns.
Hey, yeah. First we can play dress up.
And then we can play with blocks.
We can just take turns in preschool.
Town, it's Preschool Musical 2, and Preschool Musical 3, and Preschool Musical The Ice Show, and Preschool Musical
The Water True Show. Mud.
Did he say
true? Hi, my name's Mike Rowe, and this is my job. I explore the country looking for people who aren't afraid to get dirty. People with the world's dirtiest jobs. Today, I'm looking for the dirtiest job on Sesame Street.
Hey, I'll show you the dirtiest job on Sesame Street.
Yeah? Who are you?
Well, if you must know, Mr. Dirty, I'm Oscar the Grouch.
Well, you certainly appear to be living up to your name, yeah. Oscar the Grouch. Tell me, what kind of dirty job do you do exactly?
Well, I'm in trash. I collect it, I sort it, I count it, and I throw it in my trash can.
Well, I have to say, at first glance, that does qualify as a dirty job.
Yeah, it's the dirtiest. You'll never be able to do it.
Oh, I could do that.
No, you can't.
No, I'm pretty sure
no,
I could.
You won't.
I'm almost certain
you can't
I could.
Do it.
Confidence is
no,
high.
No,
listen,
no,
I've had
no,
a lot
chance.
Of dirty jobs.
No, you can't.
I would
do
like
it.
To try.
All right. But to do the job, you gotta get in the trash can.
Oh, inside the trash can?
Yeah, I work from home.
Well, I gotta tell you, it smells just awful.
Yeah, I know. That's one of the job perks. Mm. So just come around to the back door.
The back door?
Yeah.
Always wanted to go in the back.
Hey, Oscar, where am I?
Into the back door. You'll see something hanging on the wall to the right.
Uh-huh, okay,
there,
uh-huh.
Coveralls,
got
you're gonna
em.
Need them.
All right.
Look, watch out for the mud puddle on the living room floor.
I think I stepped in it.
Well, I told you it was a dirty job, so I guess you want to give up.
No. I like it. I like what I'm seeing. I like what you've done with the place.
I don't think you're going to like the next one quite so much.
What do you got?
Here's some gloves.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Now you're going to need them because you have to find the stinky cheese, pull it out of the trash can, and count it.
Find the stinky cheese? That's the job?
Yeah, in the dark.
In the dark of the trash can.
Yeah.
Find the stinky cheese.
Yeah.
And count it.
Count it.
I can do that.
You'll never do it.
Oh, I can do it. I can smell it, that's for sure. This is... That feels like cheese. Smells like cheese.
Yeah.
One.
You know it's great cheese when you smell it. It snaps your head back.
Oh. Then this is great cheese, Oscar. Yeah. And that's two.
Yeah, smells terrible, doesn't it?
It doesn't smell good, but I can't say I hate it.
Oh, yeah,
nice. That's three right there.
When you get to the next piece, you'll probably want to quit then. Yeah.
Oh, I doubt it. I'm not much of a quitter. This is so delightfully bad. And four. This one's way down here. Oh, I can't reach it. Nope, got it. Ugh. Five. Five pieces of stinky cheese.
Yeah, five.
Piece of cake.
Mm.
What else?
Yeah, well, you know, I don't think you're gonna like the next thing anywhere near as much as you seem to like this chore.
I hear a lot of chatter, Oscar, a lot of talk. What do you got?
Oh, yeah? Well, take a look at that pile of trash. You gotta sort it.
Oh,
pile it up in the right order.
Beautiful. It's beautiful. I'm on my way.
Okay, Mike, here's what you gotta do.
Yes?
Well, you're gonna make three piles of trash.
Right.
Yeah, one is all the rotten banana peels
rotten
in
bananas.
One pile.
Uh-huh.
All the smelly sardine cans, another pile.
Sardines
and all the moldy meatballs make another pile.
Moldy meatballs, sardines, and banana peels.
You got it. Now get to work.
I can do that. Yeah. Let's take our meatballs and we'll put those over here, and we'll take our banana peels, put those over here like that, and then I think we'll take the sardine cans, put those over here. I gotta tell you, Oscar, this is going pretty well.
Well, it has to be one of the dirtiest jobs you've ever done, right?
Are you kidding me? As jobs go, I would say this one is kind of a dream job.
Yeah, afraid you'd say that. Wait a minute. You're not gonna like this next one. I know that.
What do you got?
The dirtiest job of them all.
Yeah?
You gotta give my pig Spot his mud bath.
What does giving a pig a mud bath have to do with trash?
Nothing. It's a fringe benefit. Of course, if it's too dirty for you.
No. I love pigs. And if you've got a dirty one, I wanna meet him. Bring me a dirty pig.
Time for your mud bath, Spot. You ready? Okay. You ready, Mike?
Ready.
Mud bath time. Go for it. Bouncing around. Win in the mud.
Would you hold it still? It only makes it worse. It's one slippery swine.
Yeah.
Handsome pump. Hold on a second here. Come here.
Get
it.
There you go. Ah. Now there's a muddy pig. This is great. Okay.
Holy smokes, Oscar. I gotta hand it to you.
Yeah, well, I told you.
It's the dirtiest job.
It's a job only a grouch could love, so I guess you're gonna quit now, huh?
Quit? Are you kidding me? I haven't had this much fun in ages.
What?
Look, I love this job. Just because it's dirty doesn't mean you can't have a good time. Come here, Spot. I'm not done with you.
Hey, wait. That's my dirty job. Get your own dirty job. Oh, well, I guess I can't blame him. An opportunity like this only comes around once in a lifetime.
That's my foot!
And now, EMC, the Emotional Movie Channel, presents Mad Men.
So, gentlemen. Where are we with the Happy Honey Bear account?
Coming right along, Mr. Draper.
Oh, would you like for us to show you some ideas, Mr. Draper?
Yes. Let's take a look, shall we?
Okay, here we go.
Been working very hard on this.
How's that, huh?
Let's see it. But this doesn't make me happy. The raccoons are running off with a bear's honey. This makes me mad. Very mad.
Yeah, it makes me mad, too.
Very mad.
Mad, mad, mad.
We're mad men! We need to feel happy about honey. Where's the picture that's gonna grab us with happiness? You know, put a sticky smile on our faces.
How about this, Mr. Draper?
Huh?
I don't see happy here. The honey is all gone, the bear has nothing to eat. It makes me sad. I'm sad.
Me too. I'm sad. Very sad. We're sad men!
Where is that idea that's gonna pull us up out of our sadness, wipe away our tears, and make us happy about honey?
How about this one?
Now this one gets me right here. The bear is dripping with gooey honey. He's smiling. This makes me happy. This makes me happy.
I'm happy too! So, so happy!
Happy, happy, happy!
We're happy, man!
It's been an emotional roller coaster, hasn't it?
Yeah.
We've been mad, sad, and happy.
Yeah.
But good work, sycophants.
Thanks, Mr. Draper.
You're the boss, Mr. Draper.
Yes, I am. What's the suit?
Grouch B.O. presents the yuckiest show on television, True Mud.
I feel the mud between my toes. It squishes more than you suppose. Don't know if you're a grouch, but before this day is through,
I wanna find you mud with you.
Can I have a try?
I'm starving.
I get for you, sir?
Got any true mud?
Did he say true mud?
Yeah, he must be one of them there grouches. Grouches love mud. Oh, simmer down. He doesn't look like a grouch to me. Are you a grouch, sir?
What's it to you? Just get me some mud. I need mud.
All right, all right. True mud coming up. Here you go.
That's not true mud.
It's not?
It's a potato.
Oh, right. That's true spud. Spud, mud. Spud, mud. They sound so much the same. They rhyme. Guess I got confused.
I need true mud. Hurry.
Someone needs some true cud? I'm chewing on some cud right now.
Oh, no, ma'am. This gentleman wants true mud.
Is he some kind of grouch?
I'm not rightly sure.
I didn't ask for cud. I asked for mud.
Well, now, don't get your fangs in an uproar. Cud and mud have the same sound. Cud, mud. Cud, mud. Am I right?
Just give me some mud. I need mud.
You call me?
Who are you?
Name's Bud.
Oh, no, sir. He doesn't want Bud. He wants mud. Bud sounds an awful lot like mud, though. Bud, mud. Bud, mud.
Mud? You ain't one of them grouches, are you?
Just give me some mud. I need some mud.
Well, I don't have mud, but I do have this broken watch. It's a true dud.
I don't want a spud or a cud or a dud. I want mud.
That was a true thud.
I mixed some dirt and water and made you a whole lot of mud, sir.
What do you want with all this mud?
It's time for my mud bath.
Mud bath? He must be a grouch.
Now that's what I call true mud.
Oh, mind if I take a mud bath too? Are you a grouch? I just love mud.
Who doesn't?
Hey, Chief, can we go home now? I'm tired of working.
Now, detectives, you know I never go home until all my cases are closed.
But we closed all the cases, Chief.
Is that right, Sergeant?
Yes.
Now, what have we got here?
Oh.
Isn't this a pretty pencil case? Looks like somebody left it open.
Was it me, Chief? No way.
Was it you, Sergeant Gabriel? Did you leave this case open?
Yes, Chief. See, I needed a pencil, and I just...
Case closed.
Oh, my. Are my eyes playing tricks on me? Is this eyeglass case open, Lieutenant?
it looks that way, Chief. Mm-hmm.
You left this case open, did you not, Lieutenant Tao?
Yes! I needed my glasses! I couldn't see!
Case closed.
Professor, what do you suppose a suitcase is doing in the Los Angeles Police Department?
Well, I was gonna...
Is someone going away, Professor?
Well, yeah,
For a very long time.
Well, I was thinking of going to my grandma's.
With an open suitcase?
I tried to close it, Chief, but it won't close.
Well, of course not, silly. You have too much stuff in it.
What?
There you go. Case closed.
Now, that's what I call an open and shut case.
Anyone know why this briefcase is open?
No, Chief, I have no idea.
Chief, that's your briefcase.
Oh, well, of course it is. Just wanted to see if y'all were paying attention. Case closed.
Nobody closes a case the way she does.
Can we go home now, Chief?
Not yet.
But we closed all our cases.
Yes, but that's not all that needs closing around here. Huh? What about that drawer over there? And that window? That bag? That box? That off-brand notebook computer? Those blinds? Now close your mouth, Provenza. Unless you want me to close it for you.
No wonder they call her the closer.
Hello, friends. Welcome to the O Show, where we celebrate all things that begin with the letter O. My first guest loves breakfast as much as I love the letter O. Please welcome Otto the Orangutan.
Oh, I'm in love. I love oatmeal and omelets.
Well, that's obvious. Who introduced you to these healthy foods, Otto?
Dr. Oswald recommended that I eat a healthy breakfast. It was love at first bite. Yeah!
Woo! My next guest is the winner of Ocean's Most Talented, who loves to juggle things that begin with the letter O. Please welcome Ophelia the Octopus! Okay, Ophelia, show us what you've got. Is that an orange, an onion, and an olive? Outrageous! Time to share one of my favorite O things. It's an oboe! You get an oboe, you get an oboe, everybody gets an oboe! If you'd like to see more O words, check us out online. This is O, over and out.
Places in the world she had to walk into my joint. Say it again, man.
Last night as I was lying, just lounging in my bed. Heard such a loony howling, stood my hair up on my head. Lunged over to the window, flipped the floodlight right on. Hey, there's a letter L on the loose, leaping across my lawn. I heard the letter L loud.
La, la, la.
The little rebel L, he cried.
La, 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 la.
Sorry, I'm a girl named Sadie. And she and all her friends, they were
with food. Can't put you down. If you're dry toast or something wetter, whenever we take you off of a plate, we feel so great.
And we feel better, 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 better,
better, better,
better, better, better.
Cookie Monster's on the computer?
Uh-huh.
Elmo?
Who?
Cookie Monster's not on the computer, buddy.
Chris is so silly. Look, look, look.
Stop.
See? See, Cookie Monster is on the computer.
Oh, I see.
All of Elmo's friends are on the computer at SesameStreet.org.
SesameStreet.org? Hey, can I try?
Yeah, click the mouse, Chris.
Okay. Hey, you're right, Elmo. Look, there's Cookie, Telly, and Rosita. And look at all this cool stuff. Games.
Ooh, and videos.
Hey, I wonder what this button does.
Oh, Elmo doesn't know, Chris. Click on it.
Okay. Elmo? Elmo?
Yo, Chris!
Elmo?
Now, Elmo's on the computer with all of Elmo's Sesame Street friends!
And now we are on the computer, too!
Yay!
SesameStreet.org. Check it out.
Hey.